Hey guys, this is Donna from Snowmobile Labs. We're here with Tobias from OneTool. Hi.
Hi, hey.
How's the Web Summit going for you?
It's pretty good, actually. There's so many people out there, and we make so many good connections. We like it, yeah.
And can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, so OneTool is aggregating all the leading SaaS tools together on one platform.
Yeah.
And so on the one subscription, and it means instead of signing up for new employees on every platform like Slack, Dropbox, we have an administrator dashboard where an admin can create a user and all licenses which he needs for the user with one click.
Your tool basically aggregates every single platform that a startup like yourself, like myself, that we might need. How do you sell your idea to them?
Sure. So first of all, so we reach out to them mostly over connections, LinkedIn, or we send out a performance or over performance marketing like outreach emails. We're looking for partnership managers at those companies. So and what we did as well in the past, we scraped data from let's say all the SaaS companies which are interested for us, and we reach out to them, and then we're setting up like appointment. It means we're having a video call where we talk about like the benefits for them. The benefits are mostly like they have with us zero customer acquisition costs, and they're getting, let's say, customers for free, right? And we're helping them to scale their business, and then we're having a business call and then an integration call, and then at the end we integrate them. The best approach was always like having like an introduction with someone, like, hey, I have a friend, he works for PandaDoc, please introduce me. That worked, and then we met with an online meeting, and well, we always do an online meeting, and then we talk about the business and then the terms, and that's basically it.
So what would be a sales strategy for a tool like yours? You seem like this tool seems interesting enough to sell itself, so I'm wondering, how does that look?
So as I already mentioned, it's we try to solve the chicken and egg problem, right? Because we need partners on board to get customers, and that's why we have to reach out to a large number of SaaS partners, and that's what we're basically doing with outreach emails and personal intros. And outreach emails, as I already mentioned, we have a list of all the SaaS companies which are important for us to integrate, and that's where we send up like mass emails, and they are really successful so far for us.
What is the conversion rate, would you say?
From an email to a full integration, it's around like 10%. It's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
It was really successful, yeah.
And 2019 is coming to an end. What was your biggest achievement of the year, and what was your biggest mistake of the year?
The biggest achievement, so we founded this company back in April, just like a few months ago, right?
Yeah.
So achievement was we got accepted the German Accelerator Program, and yesterday we had an interview with Y Combinator, so we went to Paris for an interview. So it was a big achievement, especially get recognized by a big program like Y Combinator. That was a big achievement. And besides that, of course, like running a startup, it's up and down. You always have like really bad days where it's like, oh my God, we had an interview with Salesforce and then we missed it. We had a really bad conversation. And you always have days like that. But there's nothing particular which was really bad. We made some sales decisions which were not great. Like we had a salesperson which was not, which didn't work out, but it was basically, the worst decision, right? But it happens.
And so my last question is, what advice would you give to someone considering starting a startup? What is the first thing you need to do to make sure that people actually pay attention to your idea?
It's a really good question. So what we did at the beginning of the year, in February, when we came up with the idea, we created like a prototype. We created a simple WordPress page to test our idea. So we used like templates from the market and created a product similar how it looks right now. And we sold the product without even having the product. So really we created a checkout process, and we sold the product with a customer acquisition cost from €9.60, which was pretty good. We just spent like 2 weeks for €400 performance marketing, like Instagram and Facebook advertisement. And that's how we tested the idea, and it proved, because people paid. I mean, we didn't collect the credit card information, but they paid, and without even having a product, and it showed us, wow, the market is there. And then we went to Silicon Valley, and in Silicon Valley, they loved our idea. They're like, oh my gosh, it's really, it's innovative, it's amazing, we need this. And that's how we like focused more and more on this idea and developed it.